final level of the Olympic Games. Who would have thought it? That's the starting seven for Fiji. Look for the guidance of Kalini Sal, number seven, number eight, Tuasova, and all of them really brilliant players in their own rights and vastly experienced. New Zealand's captain for the Olympics, Scott Curry, not able to play. He's listed there, and we think he is out of the series. No word has come up officially from the New Zealand camp about it. So it looks like New Zealand may be down to 10 players for the tournament, although trying to get a look over the top and see if we can see whether Curry is stripped of play. Who knows? There is Tuasova. This is the hallmarks of a classic, because the weather conditions could even out the current form from earlier in the 2 days of play. Gillies Kaka is partnered in the midfield for New Zealand with Gus Pulu, as New Zealand in the dark black colours kick off against Fiji in the white and black. Olympic quarterfinals, and straight away it's taken upfield by Leone Nakarawa.
Release, Kaka, release.
And now the referee stamps his role in the game. He wants a quick release. It goes away through Rabugu, who's on the field. He's probably the goal kicker as well. And Fiji coming up the halfway there. Remember, New Zealand has the two brothers, the Ioane brothers. And there is Dixon, Sam Dixon from New Zealand. And the kick through by Tim Mickelson. Pressure now. Kalini Sau, the two captains meet. Kalini Sau and Mickelson. Referee might step in here. Now the ball is cleared. And space created for removal. Nakarawa, halfway. Tuasova. Look at the power of this guy. A big chase back by DJ Forbes. Big New Zealand defence going back. But spun out wide to Verimalua. He didn't have the confidence in the slippery conditions to go for the corner. Now it's come back to Kalini Sau, who dashes forward, slips it to Tuasova. He's tipped over brilliantly by Rico Ioane. But now it goes out to Rabubu, and they are going to get the try, and the captain is going to get it first for Fiji. Osea Kalini Sau. Well, will they be able to keep up the pressure and the pace? Look at that scramble by Gillies Kaka and the enormous power of Josua Tuasova. And then the whipped pass to Kalini Sau, who must have sprung to his feet after being earlier in the movement just seconds before, and he was over for the try. Boo-boo. The conversion attempt from wide out. Making off the tour, 52 World Series stops along the way. None of them have played at home, so he's always traveling. In recent times, we'll see Kalini Sau. There is the older of the brothers, that's Akira Ioane. He's 21. Gillies Kaka was on the bench, and Gus Pulu started last time for New Zealand, but in this outing, they are both in the starting lineup for New Zealand. Now here's New Zealand with possession. Kaka out wide, the two brothers working well here. Now here is Pulu. He is very aggressive. So too is Sione Molia, who's on the bench for this one. Dixon, he's good for the leaping and the jumping, and that's a head high. Let's see what the referee says. He just says, go back. They're very strict on head highs here. And that was quite a strong hit across the front of the face of Dixon. Let's look at it again.
There we go.
We've got it pretty right. Leone Nakarawa. Didn't it? 5-0 to Fiji. 3 minutes to play first half. Kaka. Oh, straight through. Pulu. was held and didn't release. Just pulled. But there are holes in the Fiji team. There might be holes in the New Zealand team as well. Semi Kunitani. First time we've seen him. He's a danger too. Big looping passes by Fiji. There's the try scorer. And there is Rabubu. Playing it back to Jerry Tuwa. Look! He's slammed. Mr. Rasta Rasavendi.
Break up.
Have a yellow card here. What's he saying? Yes.
10. Dangerous tackle.
Rico Ioane has been sent to the bin for a dangerous tackle. Picked up his opponent and tipped him and didn't look after him to the satisfaction of the referee on the way down. Now, to his server, New Zealand are 6-7 in this quarterfinal. Not yet, remember, the team that loses
holding
goes out of the chances of a gold medal. And there is Rico Ioane in the bin. 2 minutes time in the bin. There is the tackle. Yep, the feet were above the... he looks confused, but the referee's made the right call there. Feet were above the perpendicular, and he was not denied permitted that at all. He runs around. 5:05 in the afternoon local time. 5-0. This is where New Zealand goes into the kind of a slow-mo, trying to occupy the time while the man is in the bin. That's a good attack. A catch by Dixon. Forbes tough. So this is where New Zealand can win this game if they use their big man, their toughness. Here's one from Tucker. Picked into the backfield, and he's got the try. A brilliant piece of play. I think he's landed on the ball. It's knocked the wind out of him. But what a brilliant piece of play by Kaka. Fiji did not expect that. Here it goes. Pop. Good bounce. Tuai was there and he landed on, took the wind right out of his torso. These players are so adept these days. They can kick the ball to make sure it tumbles end over end and not skips to the left or right. You see the way the ball is bouncing there? And it bounced perfectly for Kaka. And the conversion is over as well. And amazingly, New Zealand with a man on the bench ahead by 7-5. Now the got a tactic to use their big men as the siren goes for half time, and Fiji will try to make this count. But New Zealand have stopped them at the 22. Getting a lure. That's a loose pass. Dixon's onto it. Rico Ioane is back on the field, and that may well be half time. It is half time. So New Zealand played a very good period of play when they didn't have 7 players off the field. To the right, to see Rico Ioane. He's back in the game. They score a converted try. And at halftime, New Zealand leads Fiji by 7-5. There's a high expectation on Coach Ryan and the team. The losing team can still go into a battle for a medal. But it's the winning of the goal that's the one they want. And there's Dixon doing his job as the second half begins. New Zealand not, not releasing. And Fiji now the first running possession of the second half. New Zealand leading by 2. New Zealand didn't go back 10. The referee's going to stop the play. Called advantage, we heard. Advantage over, he says. Now the play roars on. New Zealand trying to pull down these Fiji attacks. There's Rico Ioane tackling brilliantly on Tuasova. New Zealand now fanning across as this attack begins from Jasa Verimalua, most accomplished player. Fires a good pass across to Kunitani. Again, it's Joshua Tuasova. So sad for him that his brother Pio Tuai couldn't come on the tour because of injury. to the Olympic Games in Rio. His cousin Jerry Tuai is there. New Zealand driving in hard there. And a penalty for Fiji. They've got three up to the left now. Dixon is waiting at the back. Here comes Jerry Tuai. And he's through. And it's round behind the post. And Fiji will get the lead again. Jerry Tuai. Very elusive player, Tuai. Another very experienced player. He's had 20 international tournament events. 10-7 to Fiji. And the kick makes it 12-7. It's not yet out past the 7-point cushion. Look at the strain on these guys. They've just up there at Malua. He's a big leaper and catcher. So too is New Zealand. It's advantage for Black from Akira Yuana. And seems to be a bit of a tussle there. A late charge putting down Akira Yuana. And an early charge, no loss forward by New Zealand. Fiji hit. Referee says play on. Here is Verimalua. Here is Kunitana. New Zealand desperate tackling. That time coming in from Regan Ware. It's the pressure game, isn't it? Because players are slipping and losing contact with the ball. Halfway line now. Here goes a kick through by Ravuvu.
Let's go. Locked there by Black. And on four. Pavia by Black.
So no one's really playing well in an incredible tight situation. The ball is slipping. So it's slipping from players. Players are falling away from tackles. Players are missing tackles because of the slippiness of the, perhaps the bodies. The wetness of the body is coming through.
Set.
3 minutes to play. It's a chance for Kiwis, Kiwis, or is that Fiji, Fiji? You can't really tell. And there is a man who could be the match winner. Tuisova. Fiji in control. They don't mind taking it right back into their backfield. Now Simi Kunitani, so major, gives it to Joshua Tuisova again. He's well looked after, but two attempts to get him down. Dixon and Ioana, which means two down. That's five men looking after the rest of the field, and Fiji know that by instinct. They bring it forward. Ravupu and Viliame Mata now.
Tackle now, move Black! There's the ball.
Sione Molia, number 13, is on the field for New Zealand. Here goes Kunitani, up to halfway looking for space, pulling this out, he gets past one, two, three of the New Zealanders. Great run by Kunitani. Viliami Mata, still happy to take it into the backfield and keep it. They're playing keep ball. New Zealand has Simi Kunitani to deal with at the moment. And at last, New Zealand get possession, but they went over the top. Just 2 minutes to play now. It's still a one-score game, though, at the Olympic Games quarterfinal level. This is knife edge. This is what two nations make their sevens commitment for. In goes the tackle from Regan Ware for New Zealand. Ravuvu. Kunitani is disappointed. He kicks it away.
Thank you. Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Well, the referee's awarded a penalty for offside play by New Zealand. Offside play in the midfield by New Zealand. They're giving away a lot of penalties here. Time has stopped. 1 minute and 26 to play.
Okay, no, time's off.
timer's off.
Three.
Regan Ware.
Three, black. Three, sub.
The sub is on for New Zealand. Referee wasn't sure. Rasta Rasa-Serenghi. And here is Simisoni Viri-Viri. He's on the field for Fiji. Now he's dangerous
okay,
too. He's a
court.
Very speedy runner with great experience. So, here they go. Critical moments in the game now. Critical seconds, that's the 22-meter line there. In goes a big hit by Tim Mickelson. Out it goes from Verimalua to Kalinisau. To Tuisova. The tackling on him's been very good. Well secured by New Zealand. Now can they control it and take it upfield? Regan Ware swings it wide to Molia.
Racknow.
Rico Ioane. Mickelson. Molia. Forbes. Kaka. Forbes again. The veteran. Number one for Fiji is Domalala, Mickelson, Ware, Rico Ioane. New Zealand are trying to play their own version of keep ball and take it upfield. A long way to go, 60 metres out. Sione Molia from Wesley College in South Auckland.
Not on the last feet there.
Penalty for New Zealand. Just seconds remaining. It's got to happen for New Zealand here. They led by 7-5 at halftime. Ben Ryan, coach of Fiji. Not often you see him agitated. Perhaps trying to bring on 7 other Rawatha.
8. 8. Sub. 8.
Tuisova is subbed off. And here is Rawatha. Now this guy is a real match winner, but there's only seconds to play. There's the New Zealand coach. They've got to score it from here. No time left. No time like the present. And it's gone to Regan Ware. Takes it forward. This young man came into the team this year. He's gone out to midfield to Akira Ioane. New Zealand have conceded a penalty.
Lever, 11.
Rawatha very, very involved in the tussle with Akira Ioane.
11.
It's going to be whatever happens when play resumes. I think it's the end of the line for New Zealand at these Olympic Games. There's some ill feeling on the tension has built up and built up. Kalinisau, he just has to restart the game and kick it out and march on to the semi-finals.
Holding on.
And he'll kick it as hard as he can while Akira Ioane can just watch. And Fiji have won this quarter-final against New Zealand by 12-7. It's been a tough one, a tight one, but they are deserving winners. And there is Tuisova, and there are the Fijian players who march on for New Zealand. They'll play on for a ranking position only. So there are the two teams. It was tough right through. It was certainly tough at the end. And there is Coach Ryan having a word with Rawatha, perhaps about the kind of discipline that they might be needing later in the tournament. But disappointment for Rico Ioane, who scored the first try, and the rest of the New Zealand team. 1 win and 3 losses for New Zealand. Fiji progressed from the quarter-final through to the semi-final.